What a relief to get out of that desert. Now I understand why people worship the Nile. I'd forgotten that this many people even lived in the Sudan. I'm here for a Nubian wedding. Maybe I'll get a chance to dance with some Nubian princesses. The groom has asked me to be his guest of honor. The Nubian on the left is me. That was just the first part of the ceremony. Now we're at Nubia's version of the bachelor party.
Congratulations, my brother. How do you feel today?
I'm feeling very well. I'm so happy.
Happy?
Yes.
Are you scared? Nervous?
No.
No?
No.
When I got married, I was scared.
The Nubians were Christians for 1,200 years before they became Muslims in the 16th century. Some even took part in the Crusades. We've come to the river for a ritual that dates back 3,000 years. The groom cuts through the water with his sword to receive the blessings of the Nile. I hate to leave, but I have to get going. After all, ancient Nubia awaits. The next morning, at the sacred mountain of Jebel Barkal, I meet up with Irene Liverani, an Italian archaeologist.
This is the temple of Mut. So it was built by Taharqa, who is the great black pharaoh who has to fight against the Assyrians in just to defend Egypt and Nubia. So as you can see, it is well preserved, and we have beautiful reliefs here. When the god woke up in the morning, the priest or the king used to offer him cakes and milk and good food. Mm. And of course, priests were just playing music for him, just to let him wake up in joy. Mm. That's wonderful. It's a nice, it's very... joyful religion, mm. The religion of ancient Nubia.
In the 8th century BC, the kings of Nubia conquered the whole of Egypt, and this was their capital.
Wow, Irene, who built this temple?
Bianchi built the temple.
Bianchi?
Or better, he enlarged, refurbished the temple after the defeat of Egypt.
Now, who was Bianchi?
Bianchi was the first black pharaoh. He presented himself as a black man. As a pharaoh, but black, with all the features of a black man,
and this hadn't
the
been...
powerful black man, mm. Beautiful, beautiful, of course.
This hadn't been done before in Egyptian art?
black people were represented under the feet of the pharaohs. That's so interesting. Huh. And he presented himself as a black, so powerful to be kings even in Egypt.
Black African kings ruled the whole of ancient Egypt for almost a century. But how many of us have ever heard of them?
Why have scholars been so reluctant to give Nubia the credit that you are willing to give it?
Racism.
Racism?
Racism. Mm. I call it racism. Mm. And when they found this culture so interesting, so beautiful, so important, they first thought, oh, it is Egyptian culture here in Nubia.
If this were Egypt, I'd be queuing with hundreds of other visitors and a guide. But I've not seen one single tourist since I arrived here. I'm in one of the greatest tombs of antiquity, all by myself. For almost 100 years, black men and black women were the most powerful rulers in the entire world. Here at last, I finally found the treasure that I've been searching for, the black pharaohs of the Nile.
This is so beautiful.